Hi, my name is Rose Pauley. I'm a nurse practitioner with pediatric gastroenterology at Boys Town Hospital. I'm here today to talk to you about breath hydrogen testing. First, we'll talk about the preparation. No antibiotics should be taken for at least 1 week before the test. The night before, try not to eat anything containing a lot of dairy or food that causes gas, like soda. There should be nothing to eat or drink except water after midnight the night before the test. The night before the test, mix up the packet of sugar that comes with the kit with 8 ounces of water and refrigerate it. Do not brush teeth in the morning before the test. Do not smoke or be around smoke during the test, and avoid sleeping or vigorous activity until the test is over. Label all the tubes with the person's name and the time of collection. This is a very key component and should be done accurately. We will now proceed with the test. This is the breath hydrogen test that we are going to do today with Conley. It comes in a nice little kit like this, has everything you need inside of it. You will need a scissors, but other than that, you won't need any special equipment. But inside each box, there is a device for blowing. There'll be instructions on how to do this. There is the sugar to mix up into the water, and then test tubes. There's also a mailer to mail it back, but we'll talk about that later. So, as I said in the preparation, the sugar has already been mixed in with the water and kept in the refrigerator overnight. In your description of the activity, you will see, according to weight, how much of this your child should drink. It could be anywhere from 2 ounces to 8 ounces. So, first of all, we have to get a baseline breath sample before the child takes the solution. So the kit comes with 4 test tubes, and we would label all of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, with the name and the date. So, first of all, we're gonna get a baseline breath sample, okay? There's a little bag right here. This here is where we collect the breath samples. See right there? You shouldn't put your fingers in there or anything. And we want you to blow around this end of the device and keep your lips on there tight, okay? You're gonna blow into this and keep blowing while I get the sample of breath, okay? Just take a regular breath in and out. Okay, then place the mouthpiece in your mouth with your lips around it. Now you start blowing and keep a continuous breath going while I put the tube in and out, okay? So go ahead and start. All right, good job. So we have our baseline breath sample, and then now Conley would drink his solution. Drink it all down. Normally you would want to have this drank in about 5 minutes, but if they can drink it right down, that's fine. It'll be kind of sweet tasting. Okay. Now, after they drink the solution, you should set your timer for an hour, and we do the second sample in an hour. So it's been an hour. We're gonna repeat this test, okay? The same thing we did before. You're gonna take a regular breath in, you're gonna blow and keep blowing a constant breath while I push this in and out. Okay, I have tube number 2. So go ahead and start your blow. Put your lips all the way around there. Keep blowing, 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 blowing. Good job. Okay. Now we wait another hour. And during this time, Conley can play or move around. He doesn't have to sit here the whole time, but he should not eat anything. That's very important, not to eat anything. He can drink water if he wants, but not eat. Time for our third sample. You ready? You're a pro. Okay, start blowing, keep blowing, all done. You're doing an excellent job. Make sure when you blow, you're blowing as hard as you can blow. You don't have to take a deep breath though, okay? And our final sample is done 3 hours after he finished the drink, and then we will do that. So Conley, put that in your mouth, you make a tight seal. Now start blowing, and I will put the tube in, and you're all done. Good job. We're all done. So after the 4 samples have been collected, again, make sure they're marked and labeled with the time and the date and the name put them in the bubble wrap packaging that comes with the kit, seal that up, put it back in the box, put some newspaper in there to prevent it from breaking, seal the box up, tape it up, put the addressed label on it as well as the stamps, and you can drop it in the post office back to our clinic, and within a week of getting the samples at our office, we will get back to you with the results.